Lord, I come unto you. Bless our diocese of Savannah with many vocations to the priesthood, diaconate, and religious life. Give the men and women you call the light to understand your gift and the love to follow always in the footsteps of your priestly son. Amen.
Please join us singing the processional hymn, which can be found in the hymnal number 424, Festival Canticle, Worthy is Christ.
Everybody knows who I am, but they don't. I'm Father Joe Smith. I'm on the staff at St. Joseph's Candler as a chaplain priest. We celebrate God's continuous love for us, outpoured in the sacrifice of the Mass. We receive Christ in body and blood. We hear God's word this day, whether here or at home, and we ask the mercy of Almighty God, striving to do so always, seeking to be instruments of mercy, but easily, equally, being instruments of that same mercy. We pause and we reflect as we prepare ourselves to enter into the sacrifice of the Mass. We pray, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us all to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, author of our freedom and of our salvation, listen to the voices of these who plead to you, and grant that those you have redeemed by the shedding of your Son's blood may have life through you, and under your protection rejoice forever unharmed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When Paul came to Antioch in Pisidia, he said in the synagogue, "My brothers, children of the family of Abraham, and those others among you who are God-fearing, to us this word of salvation has been sent. The inhabitants of Jerusalem and their leaders failed to recognize him, and by condemning him, they fulfilled the oracles of the prophets that are read Sabbath after Sabbath. For even though they found no grounds for a death sentence, they asked Pilate to have him put to death. And when they had accomplished all that was written about him, they took him down from the tree and placed him in a tomb. But God raised him from the dead, and for many days he appeared to those who had come up with him from Galilee to Jerusalem. These are now his witnesses before the people. We as ourselves are proclaiming this good news to you, that what God has promised our fathers, he has brought to fulfillment for us, their children, by raising up Jesus. As it is written in the second Psalm, you are my son, this day I have begotten you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorium psalm. You are my son, this day I have begotten you.
You are my son.
This day I have begotten you. I myself have set up my king on Zion, my holy mountain. I will proclaim the decree of the Lord. The Lord said to me, you are my son. This day I have begotten you.
You are my son.
This day I have begotten you. Ask of me, and I will give you the nations for an inheritance, and the ends of the earth for your possession. You shall rule them with an iron rod. You shall shatter them like an earthen dish. You are my son. This day I have begotten you. And now, O kings, give heed. Take warning, you rulers of the earth. Serve the Lord with fear and rejoice before him with trembling. Rejoice. You are my son. This day I have begotten you. Hallelujah.
Jesus said to his disciples, do not let your hearts be troubled. Have faith in God. Have faith also in me. For in my Father's house there are many dwelling places. And if there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you may also be. Where I am going, you may know the way. Thomas said to Jesus, Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. These are troubled times for all of us. I'm a person who would prefer to know when the bus is coming, how many people will be on it, and every other little detail. This coming week, I was supposed to be leaving for Europe. That was pre-COVID-19. So with family, taking a vacation. Had everything planned out, hotel, weather, all the things we were going to do together. Well, that all changed. Next thing that happens is we decide as a family to take and decide upon ourselves, where can we go? And we decided the antithesis of going to Europe would be to go to Bozeman, Montana, which is where we chose to fly out to Bozeman, Montana. Well, little did we know that Bozeman, Montana is still closed. So much for vacation. And all of us decided the airfare didn't matter, but we got it back. We indirectly got it back. That's the point I'm trying to make. We are thinkers and we are planners and we want to know where our seat's going to be. And there will be more than enough. That's where these readings come in a multitude of ways. This is a faith tradition that's being passed on. To trust in God and the mercy of God. To trust in the providence of God and that God prepares a place and a way for us all. But the one thing God doesn't do is tell us exactly how it's going to happen. And it's not for suspense or surprise. It's because it's unfolding. It's unfolding based on the free will of other people as well as the free wills of ourselves. That's where we're called to believe, to live out, to recognize. And as we heard earlier within the context of the Acts of the Apostles, in a sense, we too are called to be witnesses, witnesses of our faith. Now, the other things that we're called to, and I'll remind you, we're called to be courageous, we're called to trust and to believe, we're called to share in the resources and the gifts we have received. And even though we do have social distancing, we are called to still be close to and reach out to others, particularly those we see in need. During these times, the difficulty was the old, say during the crucifixion of Jesus, and that they didn't recognize Jesus to be the Christ. Do we recognize Jesus in those that are in our lives that are broken? Those that we have come across who are in need, the poor, those who are afraid more so than ourselves, those who are ill. When things open up fully, and until then, I hope that all of us will remind ourselves in faith that we are called to reach out to the other, to recognize Christ in the other. And to see in the other the dignity of all humanity, the dignity we hope for ourselves, and to live it out. That's the way we demonstrate our faith. That's the way we return our gifts of thanks to Almighty God in sharing that which we have received and open ourselves to the amazement of what God has planned for us. May God bless you this day and all of your families. Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. With faith, with hope, with confidence, we offer now these, our prayers and our petitions.
For all who lead in the church, may the Lord grant them strength in guiding the church towards healing and sacramental transformation. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the leaders of nations, may God give them courage and strength in seeking out justice and peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those struggling with depression, anxiety, or any other mental health challenge, may God's healing hand provide peace and recovery. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the community gathered here and the local community outside these halls, may the grace of the Holy Spirit empower us to live the gospel. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, may they rest in eternal peace with all the saints and angels in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray today this Holy Mass is offered for the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Hear and answer these and all of our prayers, those spoken and unspoken, in the name of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands,
the praise of the Lord in his name,
for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept in compassion, Lord, we pray, the offerings of these your people, that under your protective care they may never lose what they have received, but attain the gifts that are essential through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Let
us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you more gloriously, when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers and the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory, as together we too pray and acclaim, Holy, holy, holy,
holy Lord,
God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You're indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the people, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving you thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. Similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Fill your heart with your Spirit,
resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation. Giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you, humbly we pray that partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who fall asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, O glory and honor yours forever and ever. Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours,
now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not upon our sin, look instead upon the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other some, or show each other some sign of Christ's peace. Separated from the sacraments, not by choice, but by circumstance. We pray for the time that that is no longer a reality, and we acknowledge the spiritual communion that we pray that you receive. We pray, by Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I choose to be one with you, O Jesus. I want your heart next to my heart, your soul next to my soul, your body next to my body, your blood running through my veins. I want your divinity, infinite, to fill me completely. Jesus, I want to be one with you in my thoughts, feelings, and desires, what I say and do, and what I do not do because of you. for I embrace you now inside of me. Jesus, I love you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Keep safe, O Lord, we pray, those you have saved by your kindness, that redeemed by the passion of your Son, we may rejoice in his resurrection, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
Yes.
May God bless us, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. This Mass is ended. Let us go in peace. Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.
Please join in singing the refrain to I Am the Bread of Life.